How effective are your social selling and personal branding strategies on LinkedIn? Maybe Shield can tell us. Let's go find out. Shield is a LinkedIn analytics tool built specifically for individual creators. It promises to help you understand what works and doesn't work when posting and building a following on LinkedIn. In 2020, I've witnessed a lot of salespeople taking their personal brands to the next level. For example, I'm someone who's been very active on social channels. I post pretty much every day and have done since April of this year. But I'll let you in on a little secret. I have no idea what I'm doing. I've been guessing this entire time. So I'm excited to find out if knowing more will help me do more. But first, let's find out how Shield is already bringing value to someone else's social game.
It's analytics for LinkedIn. I can go through and see like, okay, what was my average views, comments, engagement, etc. when I post on Monday, right, versus Tuesday. And I can see like, okay, what's the best day to post, the best time to post, you know, what topics resonate the most with my audience.
Why do you even post on LinkedIn in the first place?
Why am I doing this? It's like, I don't really know. It's just fun, right? I just keep doing it. Behind that, there's obviously still value that I'm seeing. I mean, my job that I got now was just because of LinkedIn. Like literally a year and a half ago, I connected with my current director, right? And now I have this job. I still get obviously new job opportunities as well as like just connecting with awesome people. One thing it's really good for is building trust with prospects. So I don't like using LinkedIn for cold outreach, but I like using it for warming the relationship. They see how you think. You can read someone's post and be like, I like this guy.
Keenan makes some really solid points on the value of personal brand and being active on social media. Here's his details just in case you want to give him a follow. Let's go try this out for ourselves. But first, for every shield, you need a sword. This is one of those moments when you spend some time contemplating about the fact that you spent $5 on a toy sword for a video about LinkedIn software. So straight off the bat, it's given us some pricing because you do need to put your credit card in to access the free 10-day trial. Look away, this is none of your business, okay? 1670-3144. For the purposes of being able to test the most amount of features, I'm gonna register as the highest package they have, which is the influencer. I'm an influencer. Mum and dad would be so proud. So the first thing I'm shown is a content report. Let's have a look here. So with this view, I can see how many views I've had week on week. So this week versus last week, how many likes, how many comments, how many shares, etc. My total engagement rate, how many followers I got. This seems inaccurate. I definitely didn't get 10,000 followers last week. I think that's my total number. And click the show averages button. I don't know if I'm seeing my average or averages for LinkedIn in general. It's not super clear. It tells me the frequency of how often I was posting, once a day on average. And look at this, we've got a bit of a word cloud here. This is interesting. Some of the big ones that stand out are sales, TikTok, interview videos, wonderful.
And I'm into massive, what a wonderful TikTok.
So that's actually telling me that really, it's not telling me a lot. So when I go year to date, I can actually get a view of how many views I got across all my posts. So this year I've had 1.5 million views. Huge, wow. Compared to last year, I only had 150,000 views. This paints a pretty good picture of how often I started posting as well. So like right around August, you can see that's when I started posting pretty much every day, sometimes twice, three times a day. So my top post of all time with 218,000 views. If you want to find out if someone's genuinely nice, call them pretending to be an SDR. That was only a couple of weeks ago. My second most viewed one is about showing up to your first. And then I can filter by what kind of post it was. So I can see that a text post, I can show averages and see that one of my text posts on average will get around 10,000 views. And then of course the engagement rate. If I switch across to video, I can see that my average video will get around 4,848 views, more likes and more comments. So the engagement rate on videos is higher, but the number of views is lower. I find posting videos to LinkedIn a great way to build relationships with people, but it isn't the best way to go viral. Go for maybe like an image, get around 7,000 views and an even lower engagement rate than the text post. So based on this, I should probably stop posting images. Here's the question we all want to know, polls. So an average poll gets 40,000 views, four times as many views on a poll as a text post, and almost 10 times as many as a video. The engagement rate is much, much lower. You can see it here, the average likes are 50 and comments are 79, which tells me that polls are a good way to start a conversation. I've found more recently that if you dress up a text post as a poll, it's a great way to get more views on your post. So you write your text post as usual, and then you just include a poll at the end that's relevant to your post, and that will generally mean that your post will get more views, and it gives people one more way to engage with you as well. And then we can break out and see exactly which poll had the most views. And this is exactly what I mean. One of my lowest effort posts of all time is also one of my most viewed. It's literally just poll, 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 poll. This is cool. It also breaks out the results of the poll. And then you can go into the post itself and inspect it in more detail. You can see when it got the likes and comments, which companies the people were from. Occupation is missing, but the region, London, New York, San Fran, Toronto, Boston. That's awesome. And that's pretty cool. I can actually export all of this to a CSV file for further chopping and changing. All right. I like this a lot. I'm seeing the value here. If I can look at this and see which posts have done really, really well and figure out the common attributes. For example, I'm looking at the top ones right now. All of them have upwards of 5 hashtags. If you compare days of the week instead, then we can see our average views on a Monday is 7,000, whereas a Tuesday is 5,000, Wednesday, 13,000. Wednesdays are looking like a hot day to post, folks. Thursday, 8,000, Friday, 10,000. So I just learned, at least for myself, that Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday are my best days to post. So if I think I have good content, then I should save it for those days. Or maybe it just means that I'm less interesting on Monday and Tuesdays. Then if I go to profile, I can see how many people are looking at my profile for any given period. 5,600 people have looked at my profile in the last 90 days. How many connections I have, how many followers. Start of the year, I had about 5,726 connections, and now I have 7,693. And then my follower stats. So this one's broken. If I switch up my content statistics to this time last year to now, I see that I had 1.5 million views, 18,000 likes, 5,000 comments, 53 shares, 1.5% engagement rate, 170 posts, 385 days, and 1 active user on Shield. Happy holidays, everyone. There's a little song for you. And here's that frequency chart again. And then it shows some of my recent content. I think this is pretty darn nifty. It gives me a lot more insight than what I feel LinkedIn gives me, or at least allows me to aggregate it and start to spot some trends. With LinkedIn, so often it can feel like you're just guessing and just putting stuff out there and not really knowing what's worked. I'm gonna probably spend some more time looking at what's worked and what hasn't, and then use that to craft my content strategy going into 2021. Let's just have a quick look at pricing here. So at the starter at $6, the creator at $12, and the influencer at $19. The influencer level comes with audience demographics, search keywords and hashtags, priority chat support. Creator package comes with stats comparison, visual benchmarks, content labels, network stats. Most of what we looked at and enjoyed today was part of that starter package. And I'll probably keep using this, but I'll probably downgrade to that starter package because a lot of the other features aren't things that I'm really that interested in. If you're not into LinkedIn and making content, then this probably definitely isn't for you. However, if you are someone who likes to prioritize your performance, I 100% advise picking this up and getting some more insight into what you've been doing right. Before we go, while we're on the topic of likes, comments, engagement rates, it would mean the world to me and the SalesV team if you could drop a like and a comment on these videos. It really makes a huge difference and helps these get seen by more people. If you want to see more content and aren't already, then do be sure to subscribe. And if you really don't want to miss something, then hit the bell button to be notified whenever we launch new content. Happy holidays and happy selling. See you next time on Sales Tech Talks.